And they took photos of the backside of the house, and I had pictures of the house all the way around, but I can't find them. I didn't know which lot was mine. I didn't know which pile of rubble was mine. Even though, you know, we're in Alabama, we get a lot of strong winds, even when there's not a tornado.
In this house, we have a system of redundancy. We're using metal devices, and we're using the wall sheathing with an increased nailing pattern to prevent overturning and uplift as well. Currently, Birmingham is in a 90-mile-an-hour wind zone. We have this house designed to perform at a standard of 120-mile-an-hour wind event.
This house is implementing a number of the techniques that are recommended to make a structure better able to resist wind pressurization loads. They're using continuous load path, increased nailing patterns, and reinforced concrete foundations with rebar to help tie the structure and help it resist the wind loads.
We increased the rebar in this particular house. We have six continuous rebars, three on the bottom side of the footing that are in the compression zone, and three on the top that are in the tension zone. So if this footing has a tendency to want to fail, the rebar on the compression side would actually prevent the concrete from failing. In order to install these Simpson hold-down clips, you need to know where the framing starts and where the framing ends. And the threaded rods that actually secure to the footing itself are actually placed in the actual corners of where the wall studs that they need to connect to. It takes a lot of precision to make sure that those threaded rods actually come up out of the foundation in its exact location, because these hold downs don't have any room for air. What this does is this prevents uplift and overturning in all the four corners of the house. And it bolts to the bottom of the corner stud, and then for the floor above, you just turn it upside down, and this is bolted to the top plate. And then on the second floor, it's turned up this way, and then you have a threaded rod that connects the two. So it prevents uplift and overturning all the way from the foundation all the way up through the corner studs. The standard nailing pattern is 6 and 12, 6 inches around the perimeter of the panel and 12 inches in the field. As you increase the nailing pattern, you increase the pounds per square foot that the panel can actually resist. And so that's what we've chosen to do, is increase the nailing pattern. You can increase it from 6 to 3, 6 to 4, 6 inches on center to 2 inches on center. And of course, the more nails that you use along the perimeter of the actual panel, it increases the structural resistance. We're using 36-inch MSTA Simpson straps, and we're using the same 36-inch strap really throughout the entire house. Typically, they go about 8 foot on center. We've been putting them at about 64 inches on center. The length of the strap increases if you're trying to tie the wall, the floor, and then the wall above together. What really happens in a tornadic event when a house wants to uplift, the mass of the floor and the wall, if they aren't tied together, then the wall just actually separates from the floor system itself.
The techniques I discussed just a moment ago are to help the structure resist the wind loads and better perform or survive. But for life safety, we have a different implementation, a safe room. So speaking about the structure's survival likelihood employing these techniques, it's increased significantly. However, it's not the same as keeping the occupants alive if they only relied on the structure itself. A safe room that's compliant with FEMA 320 in here would get the near absolute protection that we're after per the FEMA standards.
After talking to FEMA's mitigation team, I felt that it was a good feature to add to this house, a safe room. I can understand the technical side of it, on how you're using a 1-inch thick wood with the 14-inch gauge metal sandwiched in between it, and it really just makes good sense.
One of the things out of a tragedy like this is that the awareness increases, and there's an opportunity to inform and allow the rebuilding effort to be improved, better compliance with standards, increased techniques to help the structure survive, and so on.